sense.
Let's not reward the bullying tactics of a political party attack in a non-partisan city election. Don't end up in the Poe House. Re-elect Ed Braddy for mayor of Gainesville. Charles Goston, commissioner representing District 1, comments on the racist campaign flyer and the history of the Democratic Party dirty tactics against the very minorities they pretend to protect.
Commissioner Goston.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. I want to comment on the flyers that came out, as an elected official. And I can say it because, I went through it. And it's a shame when you have, and especially me as an African American, and I'm speaking from this perspective, when you have your own people that look just like you, who are just as vicious as they can be, okay? And they know the circumstances that we face. They are a part of the organizations that stand in the way of what you're trying to do, the improvements that you're trying to make. And that's what makes it painful for me, because they would rather see a whole lot of nothing than to see somebody stand up and fight for them that have never been fought for in the last 60 years. And that's what they did to me. One of my campaign managers is sitting out there in the audience. And I can say this with all honesty, that I told him that one thing that we're not going to do, and we don't have to do it. We don't have to get indignant. We don't have to throw any slime. And we don't have to spend our money telling lies on the other person. Because I felt like the qualities that I possess was enough to beat whoever I was running against. And I tell people all the time, I didn't just beat anybody. I beat a two-time incumbent. And then I came back in the runoff and beat the incumbent. Never had to do anything nasty like they did to the mayor. But it's always the same people every single time. Same characters, all right? And we sit back and act as if we don't know who they are. They did it to Barbara Shaw. And Barbara was nothing but a good school board representative. They did it to Bonnie Burgess when she ran for school board. They did it to Annie Orlando, okay? They did it to a whole lot of other people, the same characters. We know who they are, but we still seem to want to accept them when they come around us like, you didn't do a thing. When we had to spend money for an attorney, and I want you to listen closely at this. We had to spend money, myself, Barbara Shaw, Juanita Hamilton, Irwin Owens, to go before the Judicial Committee, because the DEC wrote a letter, because we stood up for Ed Braddy on the corner in front of Walmart. And he lied on me and said, well, he had on an Ed Braddy shirt. I had on a Florida A&M shirt. And how do you confuse Ed Braddy with FAMU? How do you do it? But we had to hire a lawyer. These DEC people sent one letter to whom it may concern, not even to the chair. And in 2 weeks, we had to go before a judicial committee, okay? Pay lawyer fees, got there. They found out that we weren't even members of the DEC, but it didn't matter. But what Barbara Sharp said, no, let me take that back. What the Honorable Barbara Sharp said a few minutes ago, sang volumes to me. Because one thing, as being a Democrat, and I've been one ever since I came out of the military, is this. If you're an African American, they only want you when they want to use you. I could not call the FDP office and get anything. Even as an elected official, I can say, why don't you investigate this? Why don't you do that? Never get a response. But you can get those people over in the DEC, Evelyn Fox and the rest of them, Terry Fleming, the rest of them, pick up the phone, call FDP, what do you want? And some people say, well, he's exaggerating. No, I'm not. Sherwin Henry ran for mayor. Didn't get a dime from the FDP. Didn't get a dime from the DEC. But the FDP sure sent his opponent $25,000, but no problem. Okay? And see, we had to go over there and confront the DEC to get them to even give Sherwin what they gave. And we got an opponent back here. He's running. He's a Democrat. They don't like him, so he don't qualify. And I'm telling you, I can say this because I experienced it. And I came through it. And when I see people get up to the, you know, the mic and have this to say and that to say, I'm saying, really? You got to live this stuff. Okay. And when you start talking about tragedy, the tragedy of this whole thing is that the qualifications of the best candidates get lost in the translation. You know, that's the sin. Is that the best candidate will never, ever be revealed for all the dirty stuff and all the lies they go out in the street and tell. Okay? So my emphasis is this. As a victim, and a recovered victim, okay, and so is Ms. Sharp, and so is Juanita Hamilton, and everybody else, the DEC is responsible right today of the Alachua County Democratic Black Caucus charter being suspended for no reason. They are. Nobody else. So if you want to believe that there's no machine, be my guest. If you want to believe that these people are not in your best interest, go ahead. But I tell you what, when we get beyond one black on the school board, when we get beyond one black on the county commission, when we get beyond one black on the city commission, then I can say with all sincerity, we are beyond it. But until that happens, what you see is what you get. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you for your comments.
Let's not reward the bullying tactics of a political party attack in a non-partisan city election. Don't end up in the Poe House. Re-elect Ed Braddy for mayor of Gainesville.